Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. From today I am going to start with the new series, it's Oracle interview question series, and today I am going to start with the session 1. Believe me, before any interview just go through these questions and you will get the good result. And one important thing, after this session don't forget to subscribe the channel. Don't forget to give some comments, your like, and please press the bell button. It's nothing, it's just the motivation for us. So let me start with the session. So I'm going to start with the Oracle SQL interviews question. It's not the PL SQL. For the PL SQL you need to wait over there. Now I'm going to start with the questions and all. In any interview, if you are going for, suppose your profile is, it's from Java, your profile is from .NET or from the Python or whatever the technology you are having, or even if you are going for the Oracle developer or as a PL SQL developer, these are the questions at least you need to remember before any interview. Believe me, these are the guaranteed question. In any interview you will get these kind of questions over there, and you need to give the answers. So I'm just going to start with the questions. Number one, the most important questions might be, your interview will get a start from these questions. The question will be, what is the difference between primary key? What will be the difference between primary key and unique? This is the first question in any interview, more or less. You will get like, what is the difference between primary key and unique? And your answer will be, suppose I'm writing over here primary key, it's a unique key. Remember, a table can contain maximum one primary key. In any circumstances, table cannot contain more than one primary key. But for unique, table can contain any number of unique key. A table can contain maximum one primary key. A table can contain any number of unique key. This is the first difference you need to say. In primary key, null is not allowed. Null is not allowed. But in unique, null is allowed. The third thing, can be foreign key for another table. Can be foreign key. Can be foreign key for another table. It can't be foreign key. Can't be foreign key. So this is what, this is the difference between primary key and unique. Always you need to remember this question. What is the difference between primary key and unique? It's not only Oracle. It's again with the SQL Server. It's again with the MySQL. Now, after, when you give the answer like a table can contain maximum one primary key, anyone can ask you the counter question, and the counter question will be, then what is composite primary key? The counter question will be, what is composite primary key? Remember, composite primary key means what? The primary key will be one. Primary key will be one. But will work in combination of column. Combination of columns. The primary key will be one, but will work in combination of column. And if someone asks you how we can create the composite primary key, so this is the way to create the composite primary key. Suppose I am going to create the composite primary key. Location is of type varchar2 of 20. Suppose I am going to give like name imply number is of type number, number of 4 or 5. Again I am going to give imply name is of type varchar2. Now what I need to do, I need to define the composite primary key. So I am going to write primary key, and it will be based on location comma imply number. This is called table level constant.
When we need to define the composite primary key, we need to define the composite primary key at the table level. So this is what, this is your composite primary key. What does it mean? Suppose I am going to insert the value, insert into emp values, I am going to give that like location, suppose Noida, and employee number 1001. Suppose the name of employee is Santosh, and suppose I am going to give, okay, it's these things are there. Again, I am going to insert the value, like insert into emp values, like in Noida there will be this different employee like 102, and suppose employee, suppose Rajiv. See, we are using same location over here, but the employee number is different. At the same time, what we can do, at the same time we can use, like location will be different, like I am going to use Mumbai, and employee number is 1001, and the employee name is suppose Sachin. So 1001 and 1001, what do you think, it's a duplicate? No. Basically, it will check for 1001 in Noida and 1001 Mumbai. So 1001 Noida, it's not equal to 1001 Mumbai because location is different. So this is what, this is the concept of composite primary key. So this is the genuine question they will ask you in the interview. What is the difference between primary key and unique? And this will be your answer. You need to remember this. Counter question will be, then what is composite primary key? Remember, the primary key will be one, but will work in combination of column. And this is how we can define the composite primary key. Composite primary key means what? Like we are inserting the values Noida, Noida. 1001, 1002, both are different because employee number is different. Suppose I am giving 101, 1001 once again, but the location is different, it's Mumbai. So this is the first question for your any interview. Up to 2 years of experience, you will get these questions, believe me. So you need to remember this. And it's not only Oracle, it's again for SQL Server as well as for the MySQL, you need to remember this. So this is the most important question, you need to take care. Now the second question I'm going with, like what is the difference between union and union all, union and union all. This is again the genuine questions they will ask you in the interview, believe me. Both are the set operator, both are the set operator. One difference is that union and union all, both are the set operator, and one difference is that, like in union, will display only unique values, will display only unique values, but union all will display all the values, whether it's unique or duplicate, all the values. That's the difference between union and union all. And remember one thing, when you apply the union, internally it go for the sorting. Internally it go for the sorting. In union all, it will not go for the sorting. Sorting means what? Internally it apply the order by. For the union all, it will not go for the order by. So this is what, this is the difference between union and union all. And remember, the counter question will be, performance wise, what is better? Remember, union all is always better than union, because in union always it go for the sorting, means order by clause will be there, like it involve the order by internally. You don't need to write order by, internally it arrange the data according to the particular order. So, and union all as such, ordering is not involved. So performance wise always union all is better, that you need to take care. So this is the second question. The third question, again in the interview they will ask you difference between delete, drop and truncate. This is again the genuine question they will ask you in the interview. What is the difference between delete, drop and truncate? Remember, delete, it's a kind of DML. Number one, DML means data manipulation language. It's belong to DML stand for data manipulation language. insert, update, delete. These are considered as DML. The second thing in DML, in delete statement, we can put the where condition. Can apply where condition. The third thing, the important thing, after the delete, you can roll back the recall. You can apply the rollback. Rollback is applicable. After the delete, you can get the record. Just you need to write the command rollback. So after the delete, rollback is applicable. Now, the next one is the truncate. You need to remember. The truncate is, it's a kind of DDL command, data definition language. We can't apply where condition. We can't apply where condition. And again rollback. We can't apply where and rollback. Like in delete, you can put the where condition. You can apply the rollback over there. But after the truncate, you can't apply the rollback. And even where clause is not applicable. Truncate means we'll remove the data permanently. We'll remove the data permanently. We'll remove the data permanently. That cannot be rollback. But remember, after the truncate, table will be there. Table will be there. But drop command is there. It's again belongs to DDL, data definition language. Can't rollback. We cannot apply the rollback. Can't apply rollback. And we'll remove the table permanently. We'll remove the table permanently. Will remove the table permanently, that we need to take care. So after the truncate, table will be there, but after the drop, it will remove the table permanently. And remember, after the truncate and drop, we cannot apply the rollback, but after the delete, you can apply the rollback. So this is the difference between delete, drop and truncate. Always you need to take care. It's an interview, important questions for any interview. Now the next question I'm going to start with, like, what is the difference between where and have it? Remember, with where we can't use aggregate function like max, mean, sum and all, like average and count, we can't apply that. With having we can use aggregate function. Like this is not possible, like you are using where sum of sal greater than 5000, it's not applicable. For this, what we need to use the having clause. We need to use the having clause. Like I'm using having sum of cell greater than 5000, it's allowed. So this is the difference between where and having. Always we need to take care about these questions. Okay, now my next question is how to display second highest salary. And your answer will be, this is the simplest answer you can give, like select max of cell from EMP. Select, for this we need to use the subqueries. We are using select max of cell from EMP, where cell less than bracket, select max of cell from EMP. EMP is the table. I'm just assuming that we are having a table called EMP. In the EMP table, we are having a field called salary. I'm just writing select max of cell from EMP, where cell less than select max of cell from EMP. Suppose this is the field we are having called salary. I need to display the second highest salary. I'm just writing select max of cell from EMP, where cell less than Again, I am using select max of cell from EMP. And this is how we are getting the answer, like 3000. 3000 is the second highest cell. 5000 is the highest one. And 3000 is the second highest cell. This is called subqueries. Basically, by the use of subqueries, we can do this. And again, if you want to get the detailed knowledge about the subqueries and all, you need to check my video. In that particular video, like one separate series is going on, it's Oracle series. In Oracle series, you will get the video for subqueries also. Now, the next question is display. My question is display top 5 salary. Or might be you get the question like display top 3 salary, top 10 salary. So how we can do this? To display the top 5 salary, what we need to do? I am just writing select cell from. I need to get the salary, okay, from. I am using select distinct cell from EMP where cell is not null. I am using order by cell DSC. Now I am writing where row num less than 6 and we are getting the top 5 salary. So this is the answer of this command question, like how to display, how to get the top 5 salary, and this is your answer. Like select cell from, we need to use row num over here. This is called inline view. And what exactly the inline view? It's again a kind of subqueries. I will discuss with some another video. It's already a series is going on. In that particular series, you will get the video for the subqueries. In that series, you will get the answer of this, what exactly the subqueries. But for the timing, this is how we can display the top 5 salary. And suppose someone asks you like how to display the bottom 5 salary. How to display the bottom 5 salary. Display bottom 5 salary. I need to display bottom 5 salary. What I need to do? I just need to remove this and you will get the answer. Here I am using select distinct. Why we are using distinct? Like we are having the duplicate record. In that case, naturally we need to ignore the duplicate values. Like 5000, 5000, 5000. I will just consider one 5000 over there. From EMP, where cell? I am using where cell is not null. Because if some null value is there, it's again the problem. So I am just going to consider the null also. And finally, we are using order by. Now we are writing select cell from this particular set of data and we are using row num. Row num is the pseudo column. In Oracle, some pseudo columns are there. So row num is the pseudo column. I am just using row num less than 6. So this is how we can get the answer. My question is display 5th highest salary. My question is display 5th highest salary. Like these are the top 5 salary. Naturally, this is the 5th highest. This is the first, this is the second, this is the third, this is the fourth, and this is the fifth. I need to display the fifth highest salary. How we can do this? In this particular top 5, if I will apply the mean of the salary, I will get the result. So I am just writing select mean of cell from. The same line I am going to repeat. Where row num less than 6 and I am getting 2450. So this is what. This is the answer for your question, display 5th highest salary. These are the guaranteed question, and believe me, for any interview you need to remember these questions. As a fresher or even as an experience, you need to remember these questions. I am writing select mean of cell from EMP like this. My question is how to delete duplicate record from the table. Suppose question is how to delete duplicate record from the table. Suppose I am going to create a table. Create table demo 1. In demo 1, suppose we are having a table field called role is of type number 4. And I am going to use name is of type varchar 2 of 20. I am going to insert the value, insert into demo 1 values. I am going to give like roll number 1 and name is this one. Again I am going to insert the same value. Okay, again I am going to use like this. Again I am going to apply this. Again I am going to apply this. So this is the data we are having. Select start from demo 1. and we are having like duplicate recorder there. What I need to do, I need to remove the duplicate record. I don't want to show the unique record only. My question is, I want to remove the duplicate record, like 1 1 1 AA, three records are there. I just need to remove two. Again, I need to remove two. So how we can do this? For this, we need to use the row ID, and this is how we can do this. I am writing delete from the name of the table, name of the table, where row ID not in, and I am writing select max of row ID from the name of the table, select max of row ID from demo 1, group by row, 4 record deleted, apply select star from demo 1. So the important thing is we have to use the row ID. Row ID, you are, it's again a pseudo column, like row num, it's contain the ID of the row. So this is the answer of this question, like delete from demo 1 where row ID not in. You need to give the answer like this. So these are the guaranteed kind of questions always you need to remember. These are the most important questions for the fresher. It's again the most important. Even up to 2 years of experience, you need to ready for these questions. And even for the experience, you need to give the answer of these questions. Again, suppose my question is, what I need to do? Display number of columns in the table. What I need to do, I need to display number of columns in the table. Suppose this is the table we are having, describe EMP. We are having the EMP table. In the EMP table, we are using imply number, imply name, job, MGR, hire date. So how many fields are there? I just need to count. Total 8 fields are there. So how we can do this? I am just writing select contest star from db underscore This is how we can get the answer. Like I am using select counter star from user underscore tab underscore column. This particular view, it's basically contain the detail of each and every table. You can apply select star from this particular table, you will get the detail of the tables. So user underscore tab underscore column, and I am just giving where table name is equal to EMP. And now we are getting the answer like this. So this is again the genuine question, always you need to remember. So now I am just going to end this session. Believe me, these are the guaranteed questions. Always in any interview, you need to be prepared for that. And it's not only the Oracle, it's again for the SQL Server, it's again for the MySQL. You need to prepare with these questions. Thanks a lot. And your feedback, your suggestion, it's really important for me. Don't forget to subscribe the channel. And after this first interview session, I will also go with the next, and believe me, I will give you up around 50 questions will be there, and you just need to follow my video. And believe me, these are the important questions in any interview. You just need to remember these questions. Thanks a lot. Please subscribe the channel, please like the channel, and give your comments and suggestion. It's really a motivation for me. Thanks a lot.